Welcome to NeuroCheck, the machine vision platform. In this video, you will learn how to create a new check routine from scratch. A check routine is typically used to automate an inspection task. No matter how complex your application, NeuroCheck offers the flexibility to solve it. But let's start with a simple example to understand the basic logic of a check routine. Our task will be to check the number of pills in a blister pack. Here you can see the final check routine from this tutorial. If you execute the check routine, 10 pills are counted and the check is successful. First, we create an empty application. To do so, we use the New button. Here you can also load one of your applications. Alternatively, these options can be found in the context menu. This is our new check routine. It consists of a description and an empty check. To edit the description, we select it and then click Properties in the result view. Before we continue, we save our progress with the Save button. Because it is the first time we save our check routine, we need to give it a name and a file location. It is recommended to use the suggested path to make sure to save our check routine within our project. You will learn more about NeuroCheck projects in the Project Manager tutorial video. Now we can look at the single check, or in short, check element. A check is a higher level element that contains the check functions. You can add more checks by pressing this button here. A check can be deleted via Edit, then Delete in the context menu. Next we go to Edit, Rename, to give our check a meaningful name. This is an advisable thing to do, since NeuroCheck allows you to import checks from existing applications. This way you can create a handy library of checks over time. We name our check Counting Pills. Now we can add the check functions. We click the Add Function button to choose a check function. These are the categories that group the functions thematically. The category also determines the icon of the function. As a first step, we want to load an image. We go to Acquisition and navigate to the subcategory Basic. Here, the functions Capture Image and Transfer Image are listed. Capture Image triggers a camera or a sensory device to capture an image. Then Transfer Image loads the image data into the memory used by NeuroCheck. For demo purposes, we will load an image from the computer instead of a camera. Therefore, we can add the Transfer Image function as a first function. Next, we open the parameter dialog for the added function. Make sure the image source is set to Image File to be able to load images from your computer. The demo images can be found under this directory. There we select the blister image called Tutorial and confirm. Make sure the option Always Full Image is active. Let's execute the transfer image function. The main challenge of our inspection task is to consider how the individual pills can be detected in the image. The pills contrast well with the background, so it makes sense to separate them completely from the background using a binary threshold. Let's add a new function. The Determine Threshold function can be found under the Objects category and subcategory Create from Image. Some functions are shown here with a red icon. These cannot be added, as they require input data, which is currently not provided by the application. So, here's an important tip. If you're having trouble finding the right parts for building your own check routine, click on Show Details for a short explanation of the function. There are also hints on how to integrate this function into an application. And to see the required input data of the function, we open the user manual. Here is a list of the input and output data. Besides an image, this function also requires a region of interest as an input. A region of interest is a basic object that is required by most functions. We can add a region of interest with the Define ROIs function. ROI is the abbreviation for region of interest. As we can see, With the added ROI function, most of the other functions became available. You can manage the input data of your functions in the Runtime Input tab, but more on that in another video. For now, let's parameterize the ROI function. ROIs are objects that define an area of an image. They are used to specify which regions should be further processed and evaluated by the application. A ROI can have various forms. Because we want to evaluate the entire image, we choose Rectangle. By selecting it and right-clicking, we can make it cover the full image. As a shortcut, you could also use the Always Full Image option. Next, we add and execute the Determine Threshold function. The result view shows the binary image. In order to see the modification to the input image, we split the result view and select the Input Image tab. The binary image can be fine-tuned via the parameter settings. It is recommended to activate the live preview. The result was already sufficient with a threshold of 50, and we can confirm the setting. Our next goal is to count the pills. To do this, we first have to create countable objects from the binary image. This is possible with the Create ROIs by Thresholding function. The function can be found just below the Determine Threshold function. If we press Apply in the parameter dialog, we see the function result with the current settings. The result view shows that no new ROIs were created. This is because only black objects that are completely enclosed by our previously defined ROI are searched for by the algorithm. As soon as we set object color to light, a ROI is created for each white area in our binary image. The ROIs are shown as blue areas in the result view. Excellent! We have already accomplished the most important part of the inspection task. Lastly, we add the Count ROIs function. The function is in the Analysis category, and in the subcategory Verification. When we execute the function, the red colors indicate that the check fails. 10 ROIs are counted, and the target values are between 0 and 5. Therefore, all we have to do is set the target values correctly. The Count ROIs function can be configured via target value settings instead of parameter settings. There are also functions that have both types of settings. We make sure that the Verify Target Values option is active and enter 10 for the minimum and maximum value. Then we can confirm the setting. Congratulations! You have solved your first inspection task with NeuroCheck. Remember to save your application. See you in the next video.